With the Seymour HMI, you can log data from the PID faceplate line train graph into a CSV file. This file logs for 24 hours, and a new file is created each day at midnight. The file can be stored on an external USB or SD drive. You can simultaneously log up to 16 PID faceplate graphs, or the regular line train graphs. And you can store up to 999 log files, but there is a limitation with the naming. Let's say that we have this PID faceplate line train graph on this screen. The screen name is this, and the PID faceplate object has this name. If we look at the resulting file name, it'll display like this. With this being the screen name, this being the PID faceplate graph object name, and this being the date. But internally in Seymour, that shortens into this. This is where the limitation comes in. You can only have 999 files at one time with the same first four characters. So if you need to log multiple PID faceplate graphs, make sure to name each screen that has a logging PID train graph with unique first four characters of the screen name. Now, if you have multiple PID train graphs logging on the same screen, the internal file will be the first two letters of the screen, and the next two letters will come from the PID faceplate name. With this, just make sure that the PID faceplate graph names have unique first two characters. Now, to turn on logging on a PID faceplate graph object, it couldn't be easier. Open your PID faceplate train graph object, select the Option tab, and then check this box. Here you can see what will be the name for your log file, and here you can select where to store this log file. To show you how these files look, I'll run this in simulator. I'm going to open up my virtual SD1 card. Here's my log folder, and here are my files. I'm going to select to open this with Excel. And that's how it looks. With Seymour, you get the advanced HMI tools to get the job done, but at the right value. To see more videos on collecting data in Seymour, see this playlist. To find out more on the Seymour line, click here. And also make sure to subscribe to our channel here to keep up to date with our helpful tips and products.